world ponders the mighty power of the atom, Britain's scientists are probing its secrets to aid the peaceful pursuits of mankind.
I joined in August of 1956 when there was a big boost of recruitment into the not long formed United Kingdom Atomic Energy Authority. There were dozens of us been joining every day, or so it felt like. You very much felt that this was the future.
Britain is making rapid progress in atomic work. At Windscale, a new milestone nears completion. It is the first atomic power station to be built anywhere in the world.
Thursday, October the 10th, 57. We had a works bus run us into work each morning. I remember somebody saying, hey, look, and you could just see a little wisp, a sort of light bluey smoke. Not much, just a little drift coming out of the top of one of them, you see, of reactor number one. Someone said, hey, you know, look at that. Now that shouldn't be there.
The Atomic Energy Authority have announced that some uranium cartridges in the center of an atomic pile at Windscale became overheated yesterday.
When we got to the gates, we were flagged through and told to go straight to our various workplaces, laboratories, and stay there. And I remember the word spread pretty quickly that there was a fire in the reactor, and I was given a job to do. I was going to go up onto the so-called pile top, that's the reactor top, and take measurements up there. Sitting there, up there on the top of the reactor, it was quiet as the grave. And I sat up there all night long. Remember that, a whole damn night.
Emergency at Windscale atom plant, and the milk from 200 square miles of farmland is condemned as radioactive. The trouble arose when radioactive dust from the overheated pile fell on the Cumberland pastures, but for these filter tops, once nicknamed Cockcroft's Folly because Sir John Cockcroft insisted on them, farms much farther away would have faced not emergency but disaster.
I remember the morning came. Went down past tapes put up everywhere. Don't go past this point. And water, you can see water swirling around here and then everywhere. And what had happened during the night, I now realized, was they had finally decided the only way to put this fire out. They tried various ways of putting it out, so I don't know, but they decided to pump water through the reactor. Now that reactor was not designed to have water in it at all. At the time they took that decision, the people concerned would have been extremely worried, to put it mildly. But it worked.
Now the worst seems to be over, though Mr. Stan Ritson, who helped to bring Windscale's overheated reactor under control, was radioactive for 4 days and couldn't even kiss his wife till the Geiger counters gave permission.
If it had gone wrong, the worst I think that could probably have happened would be you would have had a chemical explosion, and that would have destroyed the structure of the reactor, and the uranium would have been shot out, which would have meant at least the temporary evacuation of West Cumberland, at least.
Milk samples were found to contain 6 times as much radioactive iodine as international health standards permit. So for the time being, down the drain it goes. With atoms, you can't be too careful.